And now for your weekly dose of metal. Here are your hosts, Morgan Danielle and Luke O'Blaze, on The Metal Experience.
Her eyes glazed over with the track A is for Adulterer, also known as is for Adulterer. And then we heard Designing the Flaw. That track was called Edge of Madness. And both of those motherfuckers are playing this week, this Friday at Big Shots. Where is that, Morgan? Valparaiso, Indiana?
Valpo.
And that is both of their last shows.
Both
those bands are calling it quits. Fucking Her Eyes Glazed Over has been around for a long time. And Design the Flaw, I've played a ton of shows with those guys.
And you're playing their last show.
Yeah.
Like with Orinoco.
Our brothers in Design the Flaw.
I still have not seen Designing the Flaw.
Well, then fucking come on Friday, dude.
Now's your chance or you'll never get to see them.
Ever. They put on a killer live show.
Yeah, they're really awesome.
So, yeah, my band, The Forms They Take, we kind of suck, but we're playing. And then Orinoco, they're going to go in there and kick ass, too. So it's going to be a sweet time at Big Shots, again, in Valparaiso, Indiana. What time does it start?
7.
I don't know. So, perfect. Morgan knows. Well, I'm Luke O'Blaze with Morgan Danielle. And sitting next to me is Chin Hair of Knowledge Jr.
No, we call him the Beard of Wisdom.
The Beard of Wisdom. Okay, the Beard of Wisdom, Charlie.
What's going on?
Who's taking over for Derek in Derek's absence. He's got to make that money. And tonight we have with us, for our first time, we have 50% of the band Polarities.
How's it going?
Yeah, that's all you need, really.
Yeah, right.
Why don't you guys go ahead and introduce yourselves, what you do in the band, and who we have missing tonight?
I am Mike. I am one of the vocalists in Polarities.
Hey, I'm Mark, and I'm a bass player.
And then we're missing Dave Sims. He's the other vocalist. And then Zach Boots, and he's our drummer.
Wait, I think I got the wrong band music for tonight, because the zip file that came through was Polarities.
It's Polarities.
Okay.
We got a lot of jokes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure what I downloaded
definitely
then.
Polarities. That's
yeah,
right.
We had like Polarities.
Yeah, we make fun of our name all the time, too.
We're like Polar Kitties we have.
Polar Titties?
Polar Titties. That was the girlfriend.
Good. I wasn't the only one that said that.
Oh, no. Okay, cool.
So Morgan has been announcing you guys for the past like 2 or 3 weeks that you're coming on, and she has butchered your name so many times.
Oh, God.
Morgan, what have you been calling them?
I don't even know.
She doesn't even know.
I would love for you to tell me.
You have to go back in the past episodes and listen, because I cannot remember.
Polaroid?
It's just when I'm put on the spot, I don't speak English.
Oh, man.
Polarities or something?
I think I was calling it like Polarities. I was putting in too many vowels.
Polarities. No, you got it.
No, well, I didn't.
No? You didn't have it.
Okay. Well, this time she got it.
And seriously, I was, without even looking, I had no idea the band name or anything. I'm like, are you trying to say the word Polarities?
Yeah.
She's like, oh, I think that's what it is. Yeah, that's you goof. Well, Polarities. Why don't you go ahead and give me the whole backstory of how you guys formed?
Oh, man, we could do this the long way or the short way.
That's
well,
up to you.
Yeah, you got time for the long way.
All right, long way. All right. Well, we first started out with I had just recently left one of my older bands, As We Are. And then my buddy Dave, he was fucking not doing anything, and we were just dying to make some music. But it just sucked because we were both vocalists. And we're like, all right, well, let's get on our search. We got Zach in on actually guitar at first. Did a demo. Shortly after that, he made the move to drums. We picked up Brian Scott off Facebook. We then picked up this guy named Sean. He didn't really work out too well. I think he was only in there for like a month, 2 months. I think he only did 2 singles with us at the time. And then we picked up Mark.
And that's when things just got great.
That's when I've been in a lot of bands in my day, and this has by far been the longest lasting lineup. Yeah, it's definitely a nice change of pace.
Yeah, we knew each other too all for a while, just from the scene and went to school together and stuff. Like, I played in bands with Dave and Zach before this. We all kind of just like fell apart, and like, we're all floating, and then just like
I went to grammar school with this kid. Never really talked to him a day in my life, and then.
Yeah, it's just crazy.
Hey, you got a beard? You want to play bass for my band?
Yeah.
Yes.
You should have seen my beard. It was huge.
Dude, yeah, okay. Like, you, what's your name? The bearded...
The beard of wisdom.
Bearded clam. You can call him the bearded clam.
Okay, well, this guy, right before he had trimmed all that, it was a bearded wonder.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It's because I'm wonderful.
Yeah, there you go. But no, yeah, we've been just steady doing that with Mark and most of the same lineup until about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, very recently.
So when did you first get together with everyone? What year? Give me the dirty details.
Over 2 years, right? So what would we say, like early 2015?
Yeah,
like
early 2015, yeah.
And then with this current lineup, with everyone, how it's been?
When we started, at least 3 years ago then. But now, 2 years.
Okay.
Who we are now, yeah.
Yeah, 2 years now.
It's been pretty solid the whole way through.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah.
Except for now.
Except for now.
So you guys just lost the band member, but you're guitarist, right?
Yes.
And you're looking for a new guitarist. And before, we're going to play some tracks by you guys so people can kind of get an idea. But give me a quick idea of what you're looking for with guitarists and how to contact you guys.
As far as guitarist goes, what we're looking for is just someone who could put a lot to the table, but at the same time is on that, like, just that friend level too. Like,
yeah, you know how a band is. I mean, it's like your family. You got to deal with these people all the time. You know, you can't be in a band with someone that you just fucking despise.
It's like being in a relationship.
Yeah,
and a relationship and another relationship.
Except all none of them put out. Oh my God. So it sucks.
Yeah, like, you just get to deal with the bullshit. That's it. You can get laid in between. But, yeah.
We're looking for someone that's, you know, versatile in the sounds we've been trying to go through. Like, it's the transition period. Like, I'm not even sure where everyone kind of wants to go. Like, with our last EP, I felt like every song on there was a little different style because we're trying to get some feedback to see what to do next. But we're looking for a guitar player that can obviously write and, you know, and work well with others because everyone likes to put their parts in, you know, when we write the songs.
Whenever we'd be happy in the long run.
Very like picky with like when it comes down to recording everything, like things change like on the spot or like.
So yeah,
but no one takes control.
Open mind.
Open with it, like, you know, and then all your way or the highway kind of thing, you know.
Yeah, just basically any band that's actually trying to do something, like
no
just,
egos.
Yes, yes, that's huge. Yes, very.
Yes, yes, literally. We'll talk about False King later. But,
okay. Okay.
Yeah. No egos, because I know I suck. So,
where do you guys practice at?
We practice in our drummer's. We got it's actually pretty sweet. It's like a big bedroom, and then it connects it to a small bedroom. So we got
it's like a little
area.
Studio thing in his upstairs
and then,
house.
Yeah, like our chill studio. Yeah,
yeah, it's not too bad.
Yeah, it's really, really came together. We started out in that small room too. I don't know how the hell we did it.
Yeah, like small little.
Oh my God!
It's like a
giant thinking about it now. We'd be sitting in there. I'm like,
except we had to move because we're gonna be jumping around and shit, and it's right over the garage, and like the joists started to crack and shit, and like it was getting soft. We're like, we gotta get out of here.
It's getting soft.
Before we just go through. I'm like, my big ass, I'm out of here, man. I practice outside the room, but you guys can stay in there.
A little bit nervous.
What town are you guys practice in?
Oaklawn.
Okay.
We're all pretty much born and bred there.
Yeah, we all reside from the O'Whale. Oaklawn.
That's pretty funny. Now, you guys brought some music tonight that we're going to play to kind of give everyone an idea of what Polarity sound like. And, you know, maybe your future guitarist is listening also to kind of get an idea of what style you guys are playing and everything. So what do you guys bring for us tonight? What do you guys, music-wise?
Music-wise, I sent over 4 tracks. I guess it would just... To me, I feel like our strongest songs are most well-written ones. Yeah, there you go. Tongue twister for me. but yeah, just, I don't know. I feel like those describe us the strongest and give off what we're trying to do.
It's a mix.
That's like, I know me and my other vocalists talk about it all the time. I hate to bring it up because I'm not a huge fan of Day Remember. Like, they made something for us, but just a genty Day Remember, I guess. Just something that give you some groove and some, so like, that the melodic rhythm, you know, just something to, like, to bounce to, but at the same time, something that catches your ear and something that just, I guess, just like, just more appealing, but still like doing what, like, what we want
to
do.
Yeah, you know, you try to appeal to the masses, but just keep it underground too. I mean, I don't know. I'm not going to be on like a hit radio station anytime soon, yeah, so I'm pretty sure we can do whatever we want. I mean,
but yeah, still, I want to try to hit as many genres as possible to appeal to as many
yeah,
people,
like,
as possible.
Yeah, like, we want to be on B96 pretty
yeah,
much.
Yeah, pretty much. So 103.5, just saying it now.
Just need a good guest rapper.
That's it. That's it.
So yeah, then, like, the songs you said are from an EP that you guys recorded?
Well, one is a single that I guess that just for us was a big defining moment for us, like, as far as, like, what, where this band was kind of going.
Yeah, that was kind of like our...
It's still one of my...
Come Out song. Yeah, still one of my favorite songs, yes, too, and a play.
Yeah, definitely.
That was like, yeah, that one hit right away for us. That's a big one for us.
Yeah, it came out in 2015, and I'm still like, this is my song. Yeah, like, if I would say, like, if everyone were like, oh, yeah, what's Polarities? Like, that's my song that I would...
Yeah, that's usually one you show somebody right away, yeah.
All right. Well, you know what? Let's play that one first. Where was it recorded?
It was recorded at Always Be Genius Studios in Crown Point, Indiana by Sam Henderson.
Yep. Yeah. ABG. It's a great place. Great guys. Do great work over there. It's all
and Knuckle Puck recorded there. Real Friends. Delaware's Proud recorded a single there.
Nice.
Yeah. It was really cool. Man. When we were recording that, we were actually... Delaware's Prada was coming in on, like, the morning or something like that, and then Knuckle Puck was coming in on the evening, and then we were coming in on the weekend. So, like, we had, like, he recorded that song with the Knuckle Puck's
Yeah, I got to use his stuff.
Because his shit was just never not working
we're
that day.
We're friends now.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
No, and then, like, Delaware's Prada's, like, they got all their stuff, like, laying around. It's got Delaware. I'm like, dude, like, for me, that was...
Like, I'm going to go touch it.
Yeah, like, oh, man, I touched it.
I'm going to go sniff it. Let's get weird with this stuff.
I'm
going
to go touch the butt.
Literally, like, yeah, it was a really, it was definitely, I guess, a small detail, but something that really was like, fuck yeah.
So is this where you recorded everything at, or just the single?
Most of the stuff.
Yes, most.
The whole EP was there, too, as well, the self-titled Polarities. We recently, for the newer single that we just released, False King, that was recorded at the Nook.
Nice, Nick Nativo.
Okay, so you guys
he's
know
the man.
Oh, we recorded a song at the Nook.
Yeah, Nick's the man.
Well,
the man.
We didn't record. We had Speed Freak record our single, I Want to Rock Your Body, and in parentheses, Till the Break of Dawn.
Oh,
no, that's our official theme song
we did gang vocals on.
Oh, no.
Gang bang vocals.
That was fun.
Gang bang vocals.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Nick's a real cool dude. Definitely loved working with him. It was an interesting experience.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen it. That was great.
Yeah.
Well, fuck yeah. Well, why don't we go ahead and play that first single. What was the name of that song?
Bury Me.
Bury Me.
Yes. Nice and simple.
Let's do it. Bury Me by Morgan.
Polarities.
Boom.
Yeah.
I got it down tonight. I have to. Ask me in 2 weeks and I'll tongue twist it again. All right. Here we go.
Yeah. Hi, we're Debility,
and I'm Zach.
I'm Sean.
Johnny Taco.
I'm Ryan. They've locked us in this room. There's no food in here. I'm cold and tired. They want us to tell you that you're listening to the
Metal Experience.
Please send help.
And we are back. I'm Morgan Danielle with the Beard of Wisdom, and Luco Blaze is doing God knows what, looking for socks down here at Fitz's Beer Keys. We are hanging out still with Polarities. That was the first song that we played tonight by the guys. And was that your first single that you released ever?
No.
No?
Yeah, no, it wasn't.
But that was Bury Me.
Yeah, we had two singles released and a three-song EP prior to Bury Me. But Bury Me, like I said, that was our, like, I guess our defining, like, moment for us. And the first song that was really, like, taken in, like, we exceeded what we expected for.
Yeah, and like I'd say really creating a sound too, kind of.
Yeah, it was just we were finally establishing ourselves.
Yeah.
Now, what is that song about?
Go, Mike. Man, yeah, it's been a minute. Bury Me was, I don't know, just
good
yeah,
start.
It's been a while. It was just something that me and Dave, I guess we have a dark side when it comes to writing, especially me. I tend to start a lot of the things that we write, not everything, but I don't want to take all the credit, but yeah, mostly we have a dark side, and I know Dave, Zach, Mark, me and myself, Brian, our old guitarist at the time, we all have had our dealings with depression and whatnot. So I guess it's just kind of being.
Yeah, it's talking about, you know, just like
feeling like you're just
giving up and
buried in dirt, fucking worth nothing.
You know,
yeah,
everything is just getting blurry. You can't figure it out.
Yeah,
you should like have lyrics on you or something.
I would have to go through my notes.
No, it's okay. You don't have to dig those out.
Oh, yeah.
And what is the hardest part about writing for you? I mean, you write with other people, too. Like, do you find yourself bringing your idea and having them finish it? Or how does that writing process usually work?
Well, like, as far as, like, lyrically?
Mm-hmm.
Lyrically, I mean, I've gotten, a lot of ideas shot down. And it's just really, we just come to an understanding. I feel like we both want each other to be happy, because I know there's times where I put up a damn fucking good fight for shit I don't want or I do want. But yeah, it's just basically just being in agreement with each other and a lot of bickering back and forth and whatnot. But it always works out great in the end. I'm always happy.
Do you usually get the music first?
Music. Yeah, music always.
Yeah, that's the hard thing too. Always, you know, when you're writing music, you always try to go for originality and stuff like that. And I don't know, where the hell do you start sometimes, you know?
But like I said, with a lot of our musics, I get a lot of depressing vibes from it. So a lot of, like I said, it's a very, we have darker lyrics and a lot of sadder and problems and whatnot.
Yeah, I'd say so. We were younger then, too.
Yeah, we were younger.
A little older, more bolder.
And now you're wiser.
I was trying to think of something to rhyme with that. Just nothing.
No.
Geyser.
Hey.
Weiser excited.
Thanks for joining us, man.
So I'm back.
Oh, my God.
I figured out what it was.
What was it?
Polar titties.
Okay.
And polarities.
Oh, okay. That was a new one. That was a new one.
Polarities.
So that's another one to add to the list of
mispronunciations.
You even mispronunciated Miss.
Shut up.
Whatever that word is.
I was in honors English. I know what I'm doing.
No, you obviously do not.
It shows.
I was in it for the reading.
It shows. What? It shows. Polarities.
Now I remember that one. Yeah.
Yeah,
oh, damn
polar,
it.
Polar titties and polarities.
Hey, some of those nights I had been drinking, okay? It's not
you were
perfect.
Sober. You were sober all those nights.
I was not.
She was.
Was not. I blame it on the alcohol.
So what did I miss, Morgan?
Oh, we were just talking about what Bury Me was about. Thanks for joining in.
Sorry, polarities. We're back.
Right now, for you guys, what's the next plan?
Right now, obviously finding a guitarist. Definitely for sure one. We do, prior to us losing this guitarist, we were always a one guitarist band. We would like to explore the option with two, but I mean, worst comes to worst, we'll be backtracking leads like we've been.
Yeah, we could be show ready with one, but in the long haul, we'd like to have two. I mean, just more people, you know,
creative minds,
personality,
yeah.
More creativity.
But definitely, we're all very able musicians. Like I said, Zach started out playing guitar for us. Dave plays guitar. I dabble. I wouldn't say I play guitar, but I mean, I get my idea across. He plays everything as well, along with Zach. So we actually plan on coming out with three-song acoustic EP. Yeah.
For the meantime, yeah. I mean, we got to do something, you know. Like, the hiatus thing, like, kills me. Like, I want to get out and play, like, all the time.
God,
you know, like, this is, like, the worst thing.
It hurts. It really sucks.
And so, you guys had some shows scheduled, and now back to...
chilling at home and saying, hey, we're in a band. Check us out.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, honestly, to me, this is a blessing in disguise. I felt like there was a lot of underlining disagreements, and not a lot was said. We were just kind of going with the flow. And our guitarist, he kind of had creative control than we'd like. I mean, we pre-pro everything at his house, or like the writing process would start there. He's a big contributor with that. A lot of I do the graphic designing, but as far as like our video work, and like he did our music video, as far as the editing, all of our, like, if you watch No Hope and stupid shit like that, it's all him. And as far as like that aspect, and along with the writing aspect, like there's things that we wanted to do that we couldn't do, like, which was like the acoustic stuff. We would like to, again, kind of just appeal everywhere else too as well. So we could, like, to me, yeah, this is a good opportunity for that. We want to do a cover. We can never do that before. So now we're...
What do you plan on covering?
They should make it a surprise. Don't give it away.
Yeah, I'll tell you on your birthday.
Give me a hint. Is it going to be an acoustic cover?
No, it's going to be definitely be a full band.
Yeah, it'll be a full band cover.
I mean, even if guitarists are not, we do have some promising auditions coming up.
Yeah, we're talking to some pretty rad guys.
If full band...
We've had some response, which has been nice.
The full band thing doesn't seem so far away as when initially happened.
If somebody capable enough,
they
could catch up quick. You know, I'm hoping by, like, I don't know, fall or winter that we'd be ready to get back out and start gigging again and just hit the scene.
But, yeah, regardless, we're going to... the cover's definitely going to be something that's going to be happening. And I want to try to... I just said give a hint. I'm trying to get, like... Because if I give a hint, it's going to give it fucking away so bad.
We'll talk later.
Yeah.
Did you guys consider doing an acoustic set now, while looking for another guitarist?
Once we start, I think we've only done one acoustic session so far.
Trying to, like, transpose these songs into an acoustic style isn't the easiest thing, kind of. Like, I don't know if you, like, want to gent on an acoustic. Like, you're trying to make
so,
it...
So, yeah, we're like, rewriting.
I mean, you could, but...
We're rewriting it in the process. But, yeah, honestly, that is something I would love to do. Just, like, go up, I don't know, some small bar and fucking hit.
Yeah, no, it's definitely possible.
Yeah, definitely. And that's something I would love to do.
Gonna sit down and do it.
Acoustic gent.
Why not?
Acoustic gent.
It's
a whole new genre.
Acoustic gent.
Acoustic.
Right.
It's acoustic core.
Ooh. Yeah, that's got a nice ring to it.
Yeah.
Now, you said you guys have a music video for one of your songs.
We do.
What song has a music video?
Amar et Tamari.
What is that? What are those words you just said?
I heard tamale.
Amar et Tamari. It's French.
And what does it mean?
To love or be loved.
Ooh. Sounds fancy.
This guy.
French. So who has that tattooed on him?
No one.
Oh,
nope.
Luca.
Not yet.
Damn
no,
it.
No. No. I honestly believe in bad juju with the
getting your band tattooed on you.
Yeah, kind of. So
yeah,
I don't want. Exactly. I don't want to do. I don't want to put any Elmar. I don't want to put any of my lyrics.
What's the tattoo you got of your band?
Then? Oh, it was just a skeleton from an old band.
Infinite.
He's
Frontier.
Got very stumpy legs.
He is in the ground.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
And it sucks, kind of. Yeah.
Oh, well, no, there's some history, though. That's
why
cool.
So? It's still a cool-looking tattoo.
Yeah, yeah, dude. I like my tattoos, and half of them suck, but it's a tattoo, right? It makes me cool, kind of.
You're cool in my book.
Totally cool when my sleeves are down. On
this it's okay. Ask Luco to show you his.
Oh, God.
No, that's weird. so I kind of saw that the guy was real quick. It looked like he had stumpy legs, though.
I should probably Tom add Stumpy. Some to it. I think if I ever get back at it, I should probably extend those out a little bit.
Oh, Captain Stumpy.
He's supposed to be stuck in like a dust storm or some shit, like turned into a skeleton.
Dude, no, it's cool. He's hating on your tattoo.
it's just jealous.
Just busting your balls.
No.
So the song has a music video for it. What's the concept behind it? Is it just guys jamming, or what? What's
oh yeah,
going
it's
on there?
It was a very simple. We try to do a lot of our stuff DIY. So we met Gerard playing a show at Evolution Music that we literally got a last minute show on. So very weird how that worked out. And then
or was that Centennial, right?
Oh yeah, Centennial. Or yeah,
Centennial. Yeah, yeah.
Centennial Lanes by presented by Evolution. Yeah, I thank you for correcting me on that one. But yeah, we met him at that's distracting.
Sorry.
There's a little fight going on here.
That's just my thing. So
we met Gerard, and then we wanted to do this full concept thing, but for it being our first music video and DIY, we were like, hey, you know, let's do this a little more simpler. So yeah, it's just us in a basement, but we got some brick wall behind it. So
sweet ass basement.
Yeah, sweet ass. It was a pretty sweet basement. But
whose basement was it?
It was our old guitarist's sister's house, actually. Yeah,
your ex guitarist. It's like
our ex guitarist. Yeah,
her sister's house.
Yeah,
it's like, hey, we're gonna be fucking rocking out in your basement for a while.
Yeah, no, honestly, that was super cool. Super cool because we were loud as shit. I'm not even like. PA full on, drums, oh yeah. Yeah, I felt bad.
She was totally cool with it?
Oh yeah, surprisingly. Because I don't know. I'm about to get my own house. And
could you bring the house down?
Not quite.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's the best we could.
Yeah, the best we could, but it's in Frankfurt, so yeah, they're you know, they're sturdy.
They're sturdy.
Yeah, they're sturdy.
Concrete as fuck.
So, this song... is this off the EP?
This is off the self-titled, yeah.
Self-titled EP.
Yeah.
Did you bring that tonight?
I did.
Going to play it right now.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to play this song.
Well, let's go ahead and play this song so everyone can fucking listen to.
And be sure to look up the music video. It's on your YouTube.
YouTube and Facebook.
Facebook.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And what's the name of it one more time?
In French. Say it in French.
Amar et Amari. And the translation would be to love or be loved.
Very cool. Let's do it.
We'll find a way to fix it. Nate from Silent Truth.
This is John from A Silent Truth.
This is Justin from A Silent Truth.
Yeah, and you're listening to The Metal Experience.
All right, we just heard another Polarities track. What was that pronounced? How do you pronounce that?
Amar at Tamari.
All right, rock and roll. That was track two off of the self-titled EP that doesn't have a back.
Yeah. Before we came here, I was like, man, I should just put these backs in.
Yeah, I tried it. I was telling that story. Yeah. It didn't fit.
It didn't fit.
That's what she said.
Yeah.
I wish I could. I've heard that.
Is that a good or a bad thing, then?
A little bit of both.
It might be.
Yeah.
It's probably a curse.
That's right.
You're either too big or too small.
Fuck, I guess I'm going to go jerk off now. With both hands.
Well, that was a sweet weird. Polarities track. Hi, I'm Luco Blaze with Morgan Danielle. And we got the Bearded Clam. The Charlie of Knowledge. The
Beard of Wisdom.
Beard of Wisdom. Shit, I always forget it.
Oh, man. It's how so could you name. Forget that one?
Bearded Clam.
Because he's new to saying this.
About.
That's true, true. Well, it's about that time for some Bearded Wisdom clam juice in your earballs.
You're making this worse.
Yes.
Stop talking.
Do we have a little...
Not yet. I'm still working on what I want to say.
Okay.
Soon.
So then we just go, willoo, 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 willoo. And Charlie, take it away. So what do you got for this week?
I got some tour news.
Okay. Fuck me up with some tour news. What you got?
This Saturday at the amphitheater at Tinley Park, Incubus and Jimmy Eat's World is playing.
Jimmy Eat's World is still a band?
Incubus is still a band?
Salt, sugar on the asphalt. There's a sock over there for some reason. There's a sock.
No. No, no, no.
Also at the amphitheater, August 12th, Kings of Leon is playing.
Oh, dope. Okay.
September 6th, Deep Purple with Alice Cooper.
Oh, nice. Fuck yeah.
What? What was that noise you just made?
Did we lose you?
Charlie, where are you at?
Check.
Come back to me. Follow the light. Listen to my voice. Come closer to my voice.
That Deep Purple and Alice Cooper show, only 50 tickets left.
That's, I'm not going.
Wait, at Tinley?
Yeah, it's on a Wednesday.
Wait, at Tinley, they're like, check this out. We only have 50 tickets left. How do you sell that place out?
On a Wednesday.
Are you kidding?
On a Wednesday.
I've been there when it sold out before. It's crazy.
I didn't know that was like possible.
Oh my God, yeah. It's hard to get through. So many people.
Damn.
Talk about sweating.
Yeah, right? On a Wednesday.
On a Wednesday.
Wait, Wednesday as in like tomorrow? Like tomorrow, like if you're listening to this at home, like today, tomorrow? What Wednesday?
September 6th.
Oh, okay.
Plenty of time.
Oh,
so
yeah. Plenty of time. Oh, yeah.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, yeah, right there.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Let Charlie talk. Let's not get distracted with that. Thanks.
Seether is going on tour.
Oh, not Seether. How could you? You know my disgust with that band.
I've never seen
with
them.
With who?
They're good.
Honestly, not like, yeah, that's like some old school jams for
I like
right
them.
There.
We'll see there.
Shut the fuck up, Luco. You have no say. You
not a fan of Seether.
You lost.
Okay.
Photos from the fire and Big Story.
Big Story?
I don't know who that is.
They're playing with?
Interesting.
Big Story.
Check them out.
Big Star.
Tour starts August 5th at the Rave.
In Milwaukee?
Yep.
Nice.
It's like second Chicago.
I've actually never been there.
You've never been to the Rave?
No, I'm fucking missing out.
I got a
Luco knows everywhere around the Rave. We'll save that until
you
the next.
About the Rave!
On the next break.
Damn!
All right, Luco, stop it.
He's checking you.
So it. But
nope.
Real quick,
nope.
I got
nope.
Hammer drunk at the Rave.
Hammer drunk pissed me off at the Rave.
But ooh,
I
man.
Brought. I made it up. I brought her a popsicle.
That fixes everything.
It fixes a lot.
Who else would bring you a popsicle at the Rave?
Shut up. Let Charlie talk.
Charlie got the floor.
All right, Charlie.
I'm pretty sure it was a Klondike bar.
All right, brought you even better.
Maybe. Maybe it was both. I think both? I gave the popsicle to Dan.
Both? You're killing it, Ren. Like, how could you be mad after that?
Can't be mad after chronic
hammer drunk. All right, Charlie. Seether coming through town.
Tour starts July 25th today in Baltimore, Maryland. And they stop at
the Rave.
At the Rave, August 5th. And tour ends in Birmingham, UK, October 18th.
Okay. That's a long tour.
It's a long tour. Getting around.
World tour.
Getting
world
around. Tour. Ooh, okay, yeah. Wait,
so they're going, where did you say, the UK?
Yeah.
Damn.
Good for them.
Yeah, right?
They're from South Africa, guys. Come on.
Oh, shit. I didn't know that.
Really?
Lucky.
Yeah.
That's my little, I learned something new today.
It's your little fact of the day there?
Yeah. Good for them coming
up. On a Snapple top.
Do they speak different languages?
No, they've got like British accents.
Yeah.
They have an accent because I think South Africa was originally British occupied as a territory.
Correct.
Or is it British or French?
British.
Yeah. You're correct. So they have that like South African British
Mr.
accent.
Graham over here.
That's true. Yeah.
I've been a fan forever of them. Come on.
You would. All right. Charlie,
Remedy was my shit.
I don't know what that is. I took a monster shit this morning.
I heard you at 2 a.m.
Oh, man. I was
it was gross.
Blasting off.
Let's let Charlie talk now.
Charles, what else you got for us?
Follow up with the shit talk.
Just saw on Facebook not too long ago, Motionless and White is going to be going on tour.
It's
going
to be a good show. I wish I could go.
Who's playing?
Miss May I.
Oh, Mailbox Head?
Miss May I.
Mailbox Head.
That's what he calls him. Because he's got a box head.
Who?
The vocalist with the big frizzy
hair.
Oh, Levy?
No yeah. Shit.
That's what he calls
him. Mailbox head.
But they're
sorry.
So good.
Oh, I wish they
you guys ever watch.
Who's the other band that they're playing with? I know they're really good, too.
As I'm trying to talk, Lucas
sorry, man.
Over here.
Mailbox head.
He come had on. Bukkake coffee. Remember that. It's all
in
his
ready.
System. He's ready.
A little antsy.
Yeah.
And the Amity Affliction.
Yes, they're amazing.
Yeah, I've
too.
Heard of them. Yeah, they're sweet. Mm-hmm.
Australia always brings good bands.
Love Australian metal.
They have been
metal.
Killing it.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, literally.
Everything that's come mm-hmm. out there has been
not awesome. Even just metal. I mean, minus Parkway Drive.
Absolutely.
I could do without
them. Well, they were hot back then.
And you're done.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Don't badmouth Parkway Drive. That's my shit.
Oh, man, I'm sorry.
I still have not seen those guys.
Oh, yeah. They're so good.
I wouldn't want to see them.
Lucky.
I'm not even trying to hate. I'm sorry. But yeah, Australian bands, though. They're bringing the heat, that's mm-hmm. for sure.
Put another mm-hmm. shrimp on the barbie. Put another riff on the guitar. Something, I don't know. I suck at that. I tried.
So Motionless and White, Amityville Affliction.
Amity.
That's what I said.
You said Amity. It's Amity.
Don't you ever correct me.
There's no N.
All right,
continue.
Tour starts September 20th in Las Vegas. Stops at House of Blues October 22nd.
In Chicago?
Yep.
Nice.
And tour ends October 31st in Philadelphia.
Sweet.
Charlie, I thought you said October
34th. I did too. I was like.
The last night of the tour. October 34th.
October just got longer.
We just add a couple more days on that motherfucker. We're going October 34th.
Get your tickets now.
Yeah, you don't want to miss this one.
Oh, shit.
Some futurized shit.
October 34th. I legit believed you. All right. So
kill him, Charlie. Just kill him.
What else we got?
That's all I got.
Okay. That's all you got for tour news. You got any random news? No? All right. Just tour news.
Besides really. Chester Bennington dying.
Yeah, that's brutal.
Sad.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
Took the air out of the room, Morgan. Good job.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I had to say it.
So you brought a band tonight.
Yep.
What did you bring for us, brother?
They're called the Advent Equation.
The what?
Advent Equation.
Advent? Like the Advent calendar?
Sure.
The way he looks at you is just like, shut the fuck up, Luca.
Advent.
Let him talk.
Equation.
From Monterrey, Mexico.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
And what song do you bring for us tonight? finding it. Where is it? I know you got it. Tell me, I want to know.
A limitless life reflections.
What?
You told me a violent motion.
That's the name of the album.
Okay.
Okay.
I have violent motion.
All right. Let's fucking do it. Woo woo.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yo, what's up, everybody? You got Diggs McNasty,
Timmy D,
Corey Carmander Davidson,
and Jared Ercole from Fool's Brew, and we fucking love metal, so listen in to the Metal Experience, because there's some cool motherfuckers, goddammit, ho-ho!
We just heard the event equation with a violent motion.
All right, Advent Equation. Check them out. That was actually, we played that from a music video. Was that a music video we played it from?
Yeah.
Very cool. Check out the Advent Equation. You can check out that music video for that song up on the YouTubes. I am Luke O'Blaze with Morgan Danielle and the
Beard of Wisdom.
Beard of Wisdom. I keep wanting to say chin. Something about chin. The Beard of Wisdom.
Clef the Boy Chin Wonder. Crimson Chin and Clef the Boy Chin Wonder.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, man.
And we are still here rocking out with Polarities.
Yeah.
And I've been, sorry, I've been telling you guys some crazy stories and stuff. Oh, my goodness.
I enjoy stories.
Yeah, they're awesome.
Hey, man, just trying to.
Well, let's hear some crazy stories about the band. Tell us some interesting facts or some embarrassing moments and show stories.
Oh, where do we start?
Yeah, Mark, this would be you.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I just drink in excess a lot when we play. Oh, I'm a ton of fun.
I like long walks on the beach.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, the something that happened to me was like, remember the first show we played ever? When I first joined, we played like a house show, and like, I just got like all this new gear and shit, and like we're going through the sets, going well, and all of a sudden all my shit just cuts out, like nothing's fucking working. So like, you know, ever had that happen to you? It's like the worst thing in the world. Like, what do I do? Like, do I just stand here and like act like I'm playing, and everyone knows that nothing's coming out, or should I just sit here and like try to fix it, and then like look like that guy that's just like not playing?
What did you do?
Both. And then when the song ended, it finally tried to fix it. It came back, but it was just like, what the fuck? It's one of those moments. Like, you serious? Like, my debut just got fucked.
You know, I got one. And
what was the reason it went out? Just
I just slapped everything a little bit and it started working again.
Honestly,
I think I had bad pots on the bass that I had.
Bad so, pots?
Yeah, the potentiometers, like the knobs. We're getting technical here. I'm, like I'm kind of.
Damn, son!
Like a self-trained guitar tech.
Okay. Oh, no, yeah, he does the whole, all of our like retuning and, or like restringing and whatnot.
Yeah, I always fucking dabble in, with my instruments all the time.
I've seen one band at Penny Road Pub. I don't even remember what they're called.
It's okay, you can tell me.
This dad literally spent so much money on like expensive and guitar shit for his son, and literally.
Oh, God.
And not even halfway through the song, like, his wireless just always goes on.
Oh, God. Yeah, wireless is it's hit or miss with wireless.
You need new batteries, son.
I have one. I never use it. I think I used it once, and I just totally fucking forgot about it. Because at the practice spot, you know, it's got a little close quarters, so, like, why am I going to set my wireless up to fucking stand 5 feet from my amp?
I think I've seen him, like, twice and literally both times. Literally? Happens.
You know, some kids or some people just like they buy the things and don't know how to use it.
Yeah, I think it's mostly the dad and that bought everything.
He probably had no idea what he was buying. So you don't know how to use it.
Fuck, man, I wish my dad would buy me stupid amounts of stuff
gear.
I don't need.
Hey, Dad, if you're listening, can you buy me some shit? He's not going to listen to this. he just hates me.
No, wait, as far as some stories.
And then if he did, he'd be like, no.
Yeah, fuck everything about you.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you. No. Well, I don't know if it's too much, but we actually had we have this little place we book at, and it's always a fun time. Little Frank's Pizzeria in Burbank, if you guys ever heard of it. But we were throwing our what the hell was it? Like, it was like a Halloween show. Drank a lot the night before, and it was like to the point where like it was affecting my stomach the next day. I couldn't really eat. Smoking didn't help. A shower didn't help. Like, it was the worst. So like mid set, I poof farted.
Poof farted.
Yeah,
it's called sharted. Shat.
Whatever. Shit. Like whatever, man. Like, yeah, it was just like a shit moment. Like, it was really, it was like, oh man, I cannot believe that this just happened. And yeah, that's that would be my, and like mid or right after this, the song ended, I was just like, I have to go to the bathroom. Like, it was good timing because one of our interludes was playing. But yeah, that I would say that low key was like probably the most like embarrassing thing. So, but no one knew besides my band, because I remember like during this. Like during the set, I was like, I went up to Zach as we're playing. I'm like, I just shit. He's like, what? I'm like, I just shit.
Yeah, I remember like, that. That was great. Out.
Yeah, that was fun.
So then, what did you just go to the bathroom and throw your boxers in the garbage?
No, I was clean.
This clean.
You know, just a quick.
It's a little mud cleaning. Butt.
No, yeah, just a little mud butt.
Oh, just it was stayed in the cheeks.
Yeah, it did.
It's lucky. Oh my god, you got so lucky.
Yeah. A little wipe and run, you're good to go. Yeah.
Yeah, it was unintended, and
well, those never are intended.
Yeah, no, it was very unintended. Yeah, worst timing ever, but yeah, that
so
was.
That's pretty funny because last week, the drummer of Ability pissed himself during.
Seriously.
So now you sharded.
Yeah.
Comes full circle.
Yeah.
What's next?
That fucking sucks, though.
Yeah.
You got so lucky you didn't fucking, like, a turd didn't fall down your
pants. It was like...
Oh, my God.
I literally, like, my eyes got bug-eyed. I was like, oh, man.
That's like, not good.
Like, could this have happened at any better moment than right now?
And you finished the song still?
Finished the song. I was still jumping around like an idiot like I normally do.
So you're just fucking smashing the cheeks together... The poop's probably
show must
everyone.
Go on. Show must Worth go on.
Oh like my a God.
Play-Doh.
I mean, like, there. I still, like, I, like, low key was, like, chiller. Because I, like, I, as far
a lot
as
more
yeah.
just head movement back to back.
No, no I just wasn't, like,
it's clenching the whole time.
Yeah. it was beginning of the song, too, when it happened. I had to go through the whole thing.
Oh, no. Oh.
Yeah. Stay and, like, as far as, like, vocals go, like, me and Dave are constantly trading off. Like, there's no more than, like, three lines before the next person comes in. So there was, like, no part where it was just, like 40 seconds of just Dave. It was just, yeah. Had to stick through it.
That fucking sucks.
Yeah. Good times.
So you ran off stage, quick wipe.
Yep, I said I had to pee. I'm like, I broke the seal.
Did you wash your hands at least?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah, I'm not that guy.
It's okay. It's his microphone.
It is my microphone. I only use my microphone.
Okay.
But, yeah, clean hands, man. Right. Yeah. I'm hygiene.
Yeah, he is a hygiene freak.
Yeah.
So sharded.
He washes his hands after he washes his hands.
No, I don't. I'm not like that. He's lying.
Am I?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
I am.
I'm not a hypochondriac.
Do we have any embarrassing stories about the band members who are not here tonight?
With our band?
Yes.
Or, like, one of their stories that they personally have with other band experiences?
No, we'll be
our
band.
We never had too many problems.
Yeah,
or
yeah. The worst thing that's like considerably happened to us that like everyone knew about was like technical difficulties, which is not a Polarity show without one.
Yeah,
there's always something.
Seen
that's
us, there's
stupid.
Always something that fucks up a little bit. We just roll with it.
Backtrack. Yeah, I mean. So
now it's kind of like part of the show. You know,
we meant for the dad.
You come for the experience for that. That's what it is.
Well, you know what? Let's talk about sharding a little bit more.
Oh, I love it.
You just sharted. What's a good transition song after a shart? What was the song you guys were playing while the shart happened?
What do you think it was?
I think it was Smoke and Mirrors.
Was it Smoke and Mirrors?
Smoke and Mirrors.
Yeah, you were fooling everybody that you had to take a piss.
Yeah.
You really shit yourself.
Yeah.
Well, we have Smoke and Mirrors tonight, and that was off of the previous CD.
Yeah, our first EP.
What was that called?
Timelines.
Timelines. Why don't we play Smoke and Mirrors off of Timelines?
So people can think about you sharding.
So people can think of what you had
I hope you guys have...
What you had to do with having a poopy bottom.
Yeah, Mr. Poopy Butthole.
Yeah.
I'm Mr. Poopy Butthole.
Sounds like a South Park character right there.
It's Rick and Morty.
Rick and Morty. Mr.
Oh, is it? Oh, man. Okay. Well, I should have shut my mouth.
Mr. Poopy Butthole. Like, the fucking greatest name of any character ever.
It is. It's the best character ever. I can't get it out of my head most of the time.
Oh, man. It happened.
All right, Mr. Poopy Butthole. Well, let's play Polarity's track, Smoke and Mirrors, off of the Timeless.
Timelines.
Timelines EP. Let's do it. Morgan, stop making farting noises.
Hi, I'm Morgan.
And I'm Ian.
I'm Derek.
And we are the most of me.
Stay tuned for our new EP, Quantum, and you are listening to
The Metal Experience.
We are back. I am Morgan Danielle with Luke O'Blaze, the Beard of Wisdom.
Beard of Wisdom.
And we are still chilling here with Polarities. And that was a poo track. No, it wasn't.
It was a poo.
Poo, 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 poo. It was called Smoke and Mirrors off the Timelines EP. And when did the Timelines EP come out?
Oh, man. Well, now we're doing time frames?
We're doing time frames. Obviously, because it's called Timelines.
Timelines.
I need to know when it came out.
2014, I want to say.
Was it then? It wasn't.
No. Well, yeah. No. Am I nuts? Am I?
Think so.
Am I?
You can't, just do your research. Answer the question.
Man, if you give me 2 seconds, I will have.
And did you do the album artwork for that?
Yeah, I looking at it now, I did all of our album artwork.
Except for that one.
Oh, no, yeah. Besides that one. I re-rendered that one. The Timelines was made by Danko.
Yeah, Danko. What's his last name?
I don't even know. Farley? I just know. Yeah, he's a Chicago artist.
Yeah, he's a local Chicago artist. He's actually a really talented guy.
Fucking great. Check it out.
Yeah,
Danko Farley.
Danko Farley. Yeah.
Danko Farley.
I just like re-imaged it, I guess. But other than that, everything else was done by me. It doesn't say.
Is that picture up on the Facebooks?
Yeah, or if you want to check out our Bandcamp, we got our full discography.
Check out our MySpace.
Yeah, because MySpace is still a thing.
Damn, I wish it
Dude,
was.
Dude, I wish it was too. Literally, those were the days. But we actually released Timelines on July 23rd, 2015.
What? Almost.
2015.
Almost a little over 2 years ago.
Yeah.
We missed the anniversary by just a couple days.
We did. Damn, I wish I paid attention to this stuff more.
And now you know.
Yeah, I do. Sad. But yeah. So that was our first EP. First time fully going to ABG Studios. Before the first two singles that we released prior to that were... Were you in the band then? No, you weren't.
Well, when you recorded with...
Joe Scaletta, yeah.
And no, I was not.
ABG Studios mix and mastered it.
My experiences were all with ABG and Nick. The Nook. Nick.
Luca, what was the...
This is the Polarities?
Yes.
The Timeless?
That's Timelines. Yes, indeed.
So should have named it Timeless.
Timeless. So I was looking at it, and it's actually the picture of the self-titled EP. With the glare and everything, I didn't know there was a picture of a girl's face all covered in, like, ash and shit.
Yeah.
It's kind of a hidden thing there.
Who is that?
Just some Photoshop I did.
You didn't get a model? Be like, hey, let me cover
this. No.
It's Reese Witherspoon.
Hey, Reese.
Famous actor.
Big influence on us.
Reese, let me just borrow your face. I'm going to cover it with bukkake. I mean,
some blue and black. That's what we meant.
I'm just going to make your face black and blue.
You're going to beat her?
That just made it worse, bro.
Oops. Cut that out?
No, we got to leave that in.
All right, fine.
Yes.
What were some of the bands that got you guys into this genre of metal?
Must be a me answer.
We can both do it. Start firing them off.
Well, for me, I would say Under Oath is a huge inspiration for me. Under Oath, Drop Dead Gorgeous really got me into the yelling music.
The yelling music.
The yelling. Yes. If we're talking like that, like in the. Well, we're like a mix, though, you know.
Yeah. No. Yeah. It's.
I don't know. Like I used to like. Like old stuff like Killswitch Engage and shit like that. And then when like Periphery came out and like all that stuff, like
Gold.
The Contortionist and like Protest the Hero, like there's that big change. And then you know, like Veil of Maya and Bore of Osiris and stuff. You know, their older stuff is more my cup of tea. But as for like our direct influences for our sound, is that
for
some general bands that we like. Everybody know in my band knows I just love Tesseract.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, like North Lane, which you said Under Oath, right?
Yeah, Under Oath, North Lane.
Volumes.
Man, I just go through my... I mean, it could
go on for days with this. Like, Seosin, for me, is a huge inspiration.
Yeah, Seosin's great. Yeah, stuff like that. Silverstein.
Silverstein.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot that that really comes down to it. Like, at least for us, though, I think collectively, I think I would definitely say Under Oath is low-key. I know I keep saying that, but, yeah, it's
How dare you?
No, yeah, Under Oath, The Word Alive, and Wage War, I guess, are some of our bigger influences.
Woo, woo!
Yes. Woo, woo, indeed.
Woo,
woo. Yes. Woo, woo.
Well,
if we were to go in your car right now and turn on your CD player, what album are you listening to?
Britney Spears.
Currently, in my CD player,
Britney, bitch,
is Knuckle Puck.
Knuckle Puck.
Yes.
Actually, on the way here in my CD player, we were jamming to a local band named Luca.
Luca!
You've heard of them.
They're coming on our show in September.
Yeah, those guys
no
are
shit.
Awesome.
Well,
they
I
were
hope
just
to
jamming
God.
Their album actually on the way
yeah,
here.
Yeah, I actually, they currently lost their vocalist. One of my, a close friend, or not a close friend, but a friend, actually recorded me to try out vocals with them.
Nice.
So yeah, I hope Tommy comes over here.
That'd
and,
be sweet.
Yeah.
That'd come cool. back for That'd round two.
Yeah.
Doing double duty.
In oh, no, pants. Yeah. I didn't know. I didn't.
Oh.
No, yeah. Sorry. If that was, no, but no. Someone I know was trying. Yeah. I recorded him for his tryout.
Oh,
so, no.
Okay.
Yeah. It's cool that they're coming on here. And I hope low key that.
He makes it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
All because of your recording. Because of you.
Are you going to get royalties or anything?
No,
or
no,
if it happens?
No. I'm just helping out. That's all.
Sucker, write a contract.
We actually saw Luca a couple weeks ago. Didn't we at Bottom Lounge? Luca. They played with... I know we saw him at Bottom Lounge. Maybe not a couple weeks ago, but I know we saw him at Bottom Lounge. Stop looking at me like that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Was it the El Famous show?
That's I've seen that one.
We were.
Ah,
yeah,
we were there too.
That one.
I told you, Morgan. I fucking told
you. Yeah, Luca Rhino opened it up and Luca went on, right?
Yep.
No. We saw El Famous at the Beat Kitchen, you fool.
We saw El Famous
at the Beat Kitchen for the album release show.
I've seen Luca. I know I did.
Maybe you did.
That was at the Bottom Lounge.
We'll talk later.
Is that what I said?
Yeah.
We weren't there, Luco.
Luco. Not Luco.
Not Luca. Luco. Luco. Not Luca.
We weren't there.
Let's do another track.
Oh, my God.
While I try and figure out my life.
You're retarded. Now it's time for your turn, right?
Aw, oh, man.
Yeah, buddy.
Now it's time for...
Hey, man, look what I found!
Only on the Metal Experience.
All right, this week brought to you by Imprint Recordings. Your music, your imprint. Visit imprintrecordings.com for more details if you're looking to record. Woo-wee! We have all the way from Padoue, Italy, the band Forlorn Seas with the song Absent. And you can check out their playthrough video on YouTube outright. No, let's do it. Some Forlorn Seas.
We'll be right back.
And now, back to the Metal Experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the Metal Experience.
That's not nearly as good.
Fuck you!
Woo-hoo! All right, that was Forlorn Seas all the way from Padoue, Italy, with the song Absent, and they have a playthrough video up on YouTube right meow. And that was brought to you by Imprint Recordings, your music, your imprint. Visit imprintrecordings.com for more details. If any of the bands around the Chicagoland area scene are looking to record, even around, you know, not just Chicagoland, Rockford, up north?
Yeah.
Are they north and south? They got two different locations. Kicking ass. We'll find that out. We're actually going to go to imprintrecordings.com for more details, and we'll get back to you. So we're still kicking ass here with Polarities. I am Luke O'Blaze, Morgan Danielle, and the beard?
Yes, it's on the tip of your tongue. I hear it.
Beard of...
Wisdom.
Wisdom. Okay, the beard of wisdom. Charlie, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it all over my face, neck, and chest just for you.
Ooh, bukkake, right?
Ooh, bukkake. And Polarities. So where do you guys, where can everyone find everything that is Polarities on the information superhighway?
Well, definitely Facebook. Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram.
MySpace?
Yeah, we do have a MySpace.
I wish.
We do. No, I'm not even joking. We really do.
We have one?
Yeah.
I didn't even know this.
We do have a MySpace, so for those who give a shit.
Check out our MySpace.
We are also on iTunes and Spotify, Amazon Play, Google Play, or Amazon. Is it Amazon Play?
I believe so. I don't know. Amazon Music?
Amazon. Yeah.
It's on Amazon.
Google Play. All literally, Napster, social.
Wait, Spotify? Did you say that?
Yeah, definitely, I did.
Okay. I don't know.
You guys are on Napster?
I don't know. I think it is. It's in my little TuneCore section. Like,
what? Really?
Like, yeah, no, yeah, we're on LimeWire. 50.
Nice.
My LimeWire, yeah.
Download Viruses and the new Polarities EP.
Get them both at the same time.
So you guys are seriously on MySpace?
Yeah. I don't know how up to date it is, honestly.
Who made that?
Me.
I can't believe MySpace is still fucking gone.
I thought it hasn't closed. It hasn't just been
A thing. Like, they've updated it and they made it. It would be a great platform for music. It was, but I think it, even now, I think it's
we've talked about that
towards,
before.
If it just made headway again, I think that'd be cool.
I think it's just tough to get people to go back now to MySpace.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, the best feature was you had, like, your music on your page, like, rather than someone go on your page, you get jam start going.
Yeah, it's
shit.
Like, what is this?
Like, why doesn't Facebook adopt that in, like, some way?
Yeah, no, honestly,
that was the best.
Facebook was, like, cool when it first started, but now it's just, like, it's kind of lame, but I'm just on it.
I fucking hate Facebook. And every time I'll sit there and I'll scroll through my newsfeed, and I just fucking hate myself.
I just got an update today that it was like, you know, Facebook does that. Oh, you've been friends for this many years. It was, Morgan, you've been on Facebook for 10 years. And I'm like, fuck my life. It's been 10 years.
Yeah.
Like, what the hell?
I'm getting like 6-year anniversary things. I'm like, dude, wow.
Yeah.
But hey, good for Facebook for keeping me that long.
Thanks, Mark Zuckerberg.
I've wanted to quit you so many times.
I
hate my life every
You're
time.
You're like a drug.
Open Facebook.
Yeah. And he sits on it for hours in bed and won't get off. And I'm like, are you watching this with me? Hello?
No.
Hello? Put your phone down. He'll put it down. And then 5 minutes later, he's glancing at the same news feed he saw like 5 minutes prior.
Sometimes there's updates, you know?
Like, and I'll sit there. Like, and just hate the fuck out of my life just scrolling
through. And yet
through
you're
Facebook,
addicted and keep going through it. Yep. You're sucked into the media.
2017.
We're all addicted.
What we come to.
Yeah, got to get out of that mess. It's awful.
Fucking hate it. Yeah. Well, speaking of hating Facebook, why don't we not hate polarities and play a sweet track? See that transition?
Yes.
Damn.
Feels great.
They don't teach that in the minors. No. So smooth as fuck.
I don't know how I felt about that. I didn't think that worked very well.
Super fucking
Why would sweet. We hate polarities to begin
We don't.
With?
You obviously weren't paying attention.
No.
So what's the next track you guys want to play off of the self-titled EP?
Ooh.
What do you think?
You know, Mark, you can pick.
Want me to pick?
Oh. Yeah, I know which one you're going
to pick. I guess since talking about just wasting time on Facebook, we should play Lost Time.
Lost
Time? That's perfect.
Damn. Yeah. Damn.
See that transition he just did there? That was better than yours.
He couldn't have done that transition without my transition setup. So
I'm just learning from the best.
We play.
I'm just saying.
Don't.
I pick up quick.
Don't give it to him.
I like your style. Let's do it. Polarities. Lost Time.
We'll be right back. What's up, guys? I'm Anthony.
I'm Cody.
He's from Tom.
And we're from Waranaco. Thanks for listening.
To the Metal Experience.
Gonna get you to do that again, but just, like, you know, better.
To the Metal Experience.
That was great.
That's it. That's yeah. it.
Love it.
That's it.
Love it.
Woo! All right, we just heard Lost Time by Polarities. I am Luke O'Blaze with Morgan Danielle. The beard of beardness.
Beard of wisdom.
Beard of beardness.
Kind of like that, though.
The ham clam of spam.
You're ruining it.
Can. Charlie.
Nope. You got nothing.
I got nothing.
You're done.
I'm done, Morgan. I'm going to have to go take a nap real quick.
It's not
take
possible.
It away.
Not possible. So, Polarities has hopefully some shows coming up in fall and winter. Do you have any for sure right now booked that you're getting ready for, maybe?
No.
No.
You can't just do something right now. Who knows what's going to happen, the transition here. So, yeah, we're not going to be ready yet, but we're hoping, like I said, we're shooting for fall, maybe in the winter.
Oh, yeah, as soon as we're ready, it's going to be a quick pickup. We just need the tools.
Yeah, you got to find the right piece for the puzzle.
Yeah, there you go. Pieces. There you go.
Yeah.
And where can people? Wow, where can people get a hold of you guys for wanting to try out for the band? And what do you want them to have ready while they try out?
You can hit us up on Facebook, facebook.com/polaritiesil, or you can hit us up email polaritiesil@gmail.com. And realistically, just give us your backstory and what you're about. And
so pretty much everything that you put on a dating website.
no joke, literally no joke.
How tall you are.
I fuck hard.
Right? It's all that kind of good stuff, you know?
Yeah. Like, if you like long walks on the beach.
Right. What's your mother's maiden name?
What's your favorite color?
Brilliant, you bukkake.
Oh yeah, are you into black? Are you into coffee bukkake? Yeah.
Morgan, are you okay over there?
I'm trying to swallow my gum, but you guys keep.
Why are you gonna swallow your gum?
Because there's no garbage can down here.
Spit it in that cup.
I'm so tired of chewing it. I just want to swallow it.
Just spit it in a napkin.
No.
Or that empty cup right in front of you.
It's just easier to swallow.
That's disgusting. What a whore. What? What a weirdo.
Oh, what were you talking about?
She just swallows gum. It's really weird.
Oh.
Bad habit.
It's very strange. So anyway, Morgan, what are you laughing at?
Because all I'm reading is when you said that comment, I'm trying to look up different things for my segment. It's Devil Driver. I could care less. That's how I feel about what you just said.
What did I just say?
Forget about it. See you in the pit.
I'd fuck you up.
Probably. I'm not afraid.
All right, well.
I am. I really.
Oh, all right. Enough of that, weirdo. Morgan, take it away.
I'm going to swallow my gum first.
Gross. Throw it in the garbage.
No. This is easier. Stop looking at me. Just talk about something else. Just talk about something else.
Literally, right when you said stop looking at me, all of us looked down. Yeah. Like.
And it's gone. I'm ready. Here
That's
we go.
Gross.
All right. So.
Did you guys swallow your gum?
No.
I've never once ever swallowed gum.
Not on purpose.
Like, I think I've only done it once.
I've never even swallowed gum on accident.
You know, I did it as a little kid, and I was man, I can't like
I
let
drank
go of this
something
right now.
And like accidentally fucking swallowed it too.
Oh yeah, or you forget.
I'm like, oh shit.
I don't think I've ever swallowed gum.
Just try it.
It's not bad.
Live a little.
It's like eating candy.
I've fallen asleep with it in my mouth and ended up with it in my hair.
Yeah.
All right, so let's do a rewind. Rewind. This weekend, we went to a few shows.
I don't believe you.
So we got drenched in the rain and saw Limp Bizkit.
Oh, my God.
That
it was
fucking awesome.
It was terrible.
It was awesome.
Oh, it was pretty bad.
Saturday, we were at Warped Tour. That was a lot of fun. We
that
ran
was
into...
fun.
Anthony of Waranaco with his girlfriend. We ran into
Former,
James
we ran
of Aletheia.
Into some former members of Waranaco.
Former members of Orinoco.
Tom.
Rob and Tom.
And Rob.
And then we ran into...
James of Aletheia. Some of the guys...
And Jake and Phil, who used to be in Strength and Numbers.
Strength and Numbers.
Yep. It was a good time. And then we met CKY after the burial in Anti-Flag.
Sweet. I didn't meet Anti-Flag.
Well, you didn't want to. You were a loser, as usual. No. It was a lot of fun. We saw some awesome bands. And it was hot out. Not as bad as last year.
Guar was the best, hands down. Guar, the whole entire set was spraying out fake blood. Their whole set, it was fucking awesome.
Yeah, their shows are fucking sweet.
And then they covered AC/DC's If You Want Blood, You Got It for their last song of the night and just sprayed blood everywhere. They had everything fucking just spraying blood at people. It was sweet. I would say they stole the show. And then we watched like two songs by Bless the Fall, and then we got the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
And we went to Denny's, and I fucking housed two entrees.
You know, Denny's, I used to have like little faith in, and now it's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
It's like
really good. They stepped up the game.
Yeah, they totally stepped up the game.
Yeah.
Denny's has really always been good.
It's always, yeah. That's our go to after concerts.
You might be picky eaters. I eat every. I'm like a fucking garbage truck. So
yeah, I agree with you, and I'm the same way. I'll eat whatever you put in front of me.
I like to cook, so I'm. I don't. Yeah, I'm picky.
But it was a good time. We saw a lot in the time that we were there. I felt like we had a pretty eventful and full day of music.
After the
burial. Oh, and we saw Kevin from Elfamous. Kevin Matthew. Matthew.
That's right.
Yeah,
we did. Right by the sprinklers.
Mm-hmm, by Anti-Flag. Good times.
Last year, your Warped Tour was just disgusting.
Oh, it was awful. I was really dehydrated. I almost passed out. It was not fun. But this year was a lot better. Thank you. Cool Gear actually does this thing every year where you can refill your water bottles as many times as you want throughout the day. That really does help.
Didn't they have that last
year? Yeah.
You're not paying $8 a fucking water bottle.
It's really convenient and really awesome that they do that. Even Monster gives out like their free soda or their free drinks every year on the truck. So that's really nice, too, that you have that ability to get stuff to drink for free at a venue. So
beer out there is like $10 to $14.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have a single beer.
It's too like hot. It's too hot.
Just had water and
then,
Monster energy drinks.
Then yesterday, Sunday, we were at the Rave in Milwaukee again, and we
saw. I didn't walk around very much yesterday.
Wheeler Walker Jr. That was great. We should have been upstairs for Born of Osiris and Volumes, and we got actually asked by security if we were at the wrong show. We were wearing our metal shirts at Wheeler Walker Jr. and asked if we were supposed to be upstairs.
So if you've ever heard of Wheeler Walker Jr., it's like, I fucking hate country, but it's like country, but it's like super fucking
raunchy,
crude.
Raunchy as fuck.
His first single was called Eepsy and Kickin' Ass.
Oh, no shit. God.
So
he sends me this picture and he goes, find me this CD. And I had a Best Buy gift card. I'm like, okay. But I'm like, what the fuck is this that he wants to listen to? And we literally listened to the CD to go see Flesh God Apocalypse. And I was like, this is not the music that I want to be driving while we're going to go see Flesh God Apocalypse too. But it grew on me. I just
eat pussy.
It's really dirty. And sometimes I'm just like, I can't believe I'm listening to this. And like,
I always believe I'm listening to it.
He'll show you later. You can look that up. But continuing
on.
So yeah, check out Wheeler Walker Jr. It's for if you don't like country, You'll love
probably like it because it mocks everything country stands for.
That's pretty good.
Congratulations, Huron from Battlecross. Today was his birthday. Happy birthday. And he did a Detroit Dog Rescue fundraiser. And the whole day today, he was trying to raise $1,000 because he loves animals and loves dogs. And he actually went over his goal and got a little over $1,300 donated from fans for Detroit Dog Rescue. So awesome, awesome idea to give back on your birthday. That was really cool.
So you know what was funny is when you started that, you're like, congratulate him. It's his birthday.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yep, that happened. don't forget to check out Genotype's awesome video for Silence. They are playing July 28th at Penny Road Pub. That is going to be with Seldom Told and Divided and the Unlawful. And that is at 7 p.m. on Friday. I thought Penny Road Pub was closing down. I'm so confused that all these bands are announcing now.
I don't believe so.
That's what we were told by Silent Truth when they came on.
So yeah, they said Penny
I'm
Road
so
Pub
confused.
Was bought out
yeah.
by someone else, and the guy was like, I just want to make it into a restaurant, so.
Yeah, so they're getting shut down, and I don't know. We'll talk later.
Yeah, I've heard absolutely nothing.
I don't know. Would. False information, I guess. So we'll find out, I guess, as time passes, what happens with that venue. El Famous just came out with a brand new video out now.
Morgan, I believe it's pronounced Elfamous.
Okay, good. The Life of Living with Regret is on YouTube right now. And they also have a show coming up this weekend with Dead Ships, When We Were Kids, and Capital Vices happening at Lincoln Hall in Chicago. Limited tickets available. $5 in advance if you're interested, or $10 at the door. And that is 17 and up. And there's only 100 tickets available. So right now, you should probably get on that because they're going quickly. El Famous shows are awesome, too, by the way.
Yeah, they pack. For sure.
They do.
Yeah,
they do.
A great time.
Only 100 tickets available?
It's a really small venue from what I've heard.
What is it called again?
It's like a
Lincoln Hall.
Known venue, too. That's surprising.
Rise Against played there before. There's been a few bigger bands that I saw come through there as like secret really? Shows.
Then how do you sell it out with 100 tickets if Rise Against has played
it's
there?
It's called limited. 100 tickets. If you sell out the venue, it's 100 tickets. It's sold out.
That's a pretty intimate.
Yeah, yeah. Obviously.
Especially
that's
if you know you're a band like Rise Against.
Yeah, absolutely. Consume the Divide have a few shows coming up, one of them being July 28th at Cairo Ale House. And this is actually Jason's last show with the band. He just announced that he's stepping down. So if you want to catch Jason's last show, you should go there. And it's also Joe's birthday bash. It's called The Beach Party.
Joey Gasoline Dick?
Yeah. So you can go catch that happening, I guess. Good job, Luca.
Yeah, everyone got pretty stoked on that one.
Sons of Ra have some shows coming up, too. July 29th at Cairo Ale House. They're playing with The Fifth Fire and Soul Sharer. And that starts at 7 p.m. And they actually just announced a winner for a contest that they did for getting over 500 likes. So that's pretty awesome. And go check out their Anthropology EP that came out earlier this year. It's a really great instrumental album. Within the Giant's Reach have a brand new release date coming up for Faceless, their new single, and that is going to be Saturday. So keep an eye on their Facebook page for the new single to drop. They were one of our unsigned band picks not too long ago. Don't forget to support our friends in Contra, who are on tour right now. You can always buy merch from their website. Keep an eye out on the page as to where they'll be next, and hopefully they'll be at a venue near you. They're really good guys, and so help keep them on the road and buy some merch from them. And our friends in Victims are going to be hitting the road, too, very, very soon. You can catch them at West Chicago's Cairo Ale House August 6th. They're going to be playing The Sickness Volume 1 in full with Outlaw, and then hitting Bloomington, Illinois that next day on August 7th with Meltdown Creative Works and Sabella and Wicked World. So that Wicked. Is pretty cool. And all that's going to be playing Sickness Volume 1. And then they've got a bunch of dates coming up through the end of August. So you can also buy their awesome merch on their website through Bandcamp. Our friend Dave, who used to do sound for us, shared with us this GoFundMe fundraiser for Janelle Dunaway's medical fund. So this is what it says about it. A girl, Janelle, was trying to enjoy a concert at the Roxy in Denver on the 21st of July and was violently struck by a fellow concert goer, which resulted in multiple skull fractures, nasal fractures, and a loss of several front teeth. Jesus. And she needs three more reconstructive surgeries over the next 6 months. And the dental work alone will cost thousands of dollars. So please share the campaign with your friends and help donate to support her. Yeah, that's brutal enough. The
what
pictures are
hit with? Was that like a
the
Bruce
pictures
Lee
are pretty graphic.
That's horrible.
Yeah, so I'm not sure. So she said, let me see if I can find, I don't know. She said she had, as of yesterday, she had her first round of surgery. There will be three more. Skull fractured in multiple places up to her nose. There were pieces of bone scattered all over the place that they had to drill out. Oh. She had new gum tissue and bone grafted in over the entire area. they hammered the two teeth that are still in there into place and splinted them, and they are dead and will have to be removed later.
Holy shit.
That poor girl.
Yeah.
What
so,
show was she at?
I don't know. All I know is that this has even reached like metal injection sites and stuff because of how awful she was hurt. And his
yeah.
fucking
she got fucked up.
Fucking yeah, no kidding.
Did they catch that nasty guy?
She was of the band Spite.
Oh, yeah.
She's
yeah.
in the band
No,
Spite?
No. She was with Francine, the band Spite. Yeah, so we'll share this link for people to help donate for her. I mean, their goal is $7,000, but these surgeries cost a lot more than what they're asking. So definitely this goal from what is what they're trying to get, they'll definitely accomplish, and it'll just keep going over because, I mean, obviously that's a lot of money that they need to raise. So good for all these people helping her out. That sucks. Nobody should have to be injured like that at a show. That's ridiculous. And the fact that somebody like that hits her that bad isn't paying those medical bills is ridiculous. That person should have been arrested. I mean, that's how do you get that injured at a show? Ugh. So sad. Well, thank you, Dave, for sharing that with us. That'll definitely be something that we will help share around for our fans to donate to. And don't forget, we also have a couple events that we'll be going to this weekend as well. Because Luco,
like what?
Because Luco, you're playing shows. So here's what I got to do for you. Friday, Designing the Flaw, like Luco said earlier, and our friends in Her Eyes Glazed Over, they're playing their last show at Big Shots in Valparaiso. And also playing is our friends in Orinoco. And the forms they take, Luco's band is playing along with Prey of Misfortune, Unknown Zodiac, and Devangelist. And it's only $5, and it starts at 7 p.m. So come out to Big Shots, help support some awesome bands, and give them a good farewell. You know, they've been around farewell, for quite a while. We've seen them multiple times. And
played with them a bunch of times.
You played with Design the Flaw, but not Her Eyes Glazed Over.
No. I played with Orinoco a couple of times.
Orinoco, yeah, once. Absolutely.
Well, we've seen them a couple of times. They're really
good. So it's definitely going to be a good time. And you can hit up the bands for more information if you've got questions. And then also happening on Saturday, the show that we're going to be at is at the Underground Lounge in Chicago with Rain, Zephaniah, and Death Under Fire. And the forms they take is playing with them as well. That's a 21 and over show. And I believe that is $6. And it's called the Laser Wolf Demo Tour. Not sure what that
damn
meant.
Who's got the Laser Wolf demo?
I don't know. We'll find out, I guess, when we get there. So, that's all I got for now. And then next week, Funeral Nation is going to be joining us for their first time. I know they've got a lot to talk about with upcoming shows coming up for them. And they just recently got back from a tour.
Nice.
And then after that show, we come back on August 15th. We are going to be hanging out with Mandatory Abortions. We've been wanting to get them on for a while. They just, you know, they're a punk band. They have a lot of difficulties sometimes getting schedules together or...
Mandatory Abortions is a punk band?
Punk thrash. Yeah. So they'll be fun to have on. We'll have a bunch of questions for them.
Sounds like a grindcore band.
It does a little bit, yeah. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. Don't forget to look up everything that is the Metal Experience on themetalexperience.com. All of our past interviews, Hey Look What I Found picks, reviews from the Crips, album reviews, Q&A sessions of interviews. All of that is on our website. All of our shows from this year are on the main page. And then we've got some pictures still from Nikki Presta going through on the website that Greg needs to update with all the rest of the pictures he sent us. So a lot of awesome stuff coming up, so be sure to check that out. And then for everything else,
TheMetalExperience.com has
everything
show
everything
we have ever
for the most part
done. I think we're missing
five.
Really, that many?
Yeah.
I wanted to say I think we're missing three.
I think it's five.
Over the course of 6 years, I think we're only missing three shows.
I think it's five.
Who did we lose?
I don't know. It's written down somewhere.
Yeah. Three. There's three bands. So,
what episode is this?
Oh, I don't know.
You guys have a number? Or you
no,
don't
we never counted.
No,
we should have.
Yeah, maybe
Morgan,
one day we'll go back and count.
Count all of the shows that we have up there, and
then
add three.
That's all I got.
Jeez, Morgan.
Where can everybody find Polarities once again? And then do you guys have any merch for sale online, or do you only get that from shows?
For as far as social media and all that stuff goes, Polarities IL. And if, like, for Twitter, no, for Instagram, it's Polarities _IL. And YouTube, it's Polarities Chicago. So, yes. Other than that, it's literally just Polarities IL. And then you can buy merch online, Big Cartel, Polarities IL as well. Yeah.
IL. Come
pick some shit up.
Whale.
Yeah. You can pick up physical copies, poster, two shirts we have to offer, and we give out free stickers. So.
Hey, yeah, all the free stickers that you could handle.
Possibly want.
I'm huge. If you've ever done a show and see me walk around drunk, just handing out stickers, I do that all the time.
And I'm like just sticking them on the walls everywhere.
Stick them everywhere.
Stick them
up your ass. I don't care. Or just take them from me when I give them to you.
As long as people see them. So if it's your asshole, that's cool.
Yeah.
Means you're doing stuff.
It means you're doing
advertising.
Stuff.
Thank you. Doing your part. You're doing your part. We appreciate it. Keep it up.
Oh my goodness.
Well, also don't forget to check out the Unsigned Band pick of the week, Forlorn Seas from Italy, and then the opening bands we heard, Design the Flaw and Her Eyes Glazed Over. They're playing their final show this coming Friday. And then, you know, we got a couple more tracks to listen to by Polarities that we haven't listened to yet. Do you guys have any shout-outs or any... I know Mark wanted to say, give a shout-out to his dad.
Hey, Papa. I love you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa.
No,
I'd like to give a big shout-out to Sam and Nick.
Sam and Nick, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I definitely take a bond to my engineers and people we work with. So,
shout out to pretty much anyone that's been around us for this whole time, especially the Chicago music scene. Shout out to all the bands and the great people out there.
Yeah, we've met a lot of cool people.
I've met a lot of cool people in the last few years.
Frank from Low Country, hands down.
There's a lot of great guys out there. Like I said, Kevin Singleton, he's great. He puts great shows together. He's great promoters. The scene is pretty close, I feel, now. There's a lot of good bands out there.
That's growing.
So that's one of the main shout-outs for everyone just making this happen.
Woo, woo, woo.
Getting all sentimental.
Getting all teary-eyed over here.
Just want to kiss all your mouths.
Well, we haven't played... What tracks haven't we played off of this? As my voice cracks.
We haven't played Take Me, but if we're not... Ooh.
Mike.
That's a sloppy fart.
Not sure how much we got time for, but if
we'll go out listening to a 2-4. 2-4.
Well, we got what have we not played? They're Searching. We haven't played Take Me, and we haven't played our new one either, False King.
False King isn't on here.
False King,
no,
yeah, we
not.
Got yeah, that's another that's a
not
that's our latest release.
Our newest single that we just released
almost like was it like 3 weeks and like 2 days ago or something.
Well, why
like
don't
that.
We play What's your favorite of those three? Searching, Take Me, or No Hope? Have you played No Hope?
No Hope for sure.
Okay,
that's at least for me. What about you?
I would say Take Me.
Ooh, man! See, this is why we needed like a third one here.
So let's go out doing a threefer.
All right,
we're gonna do Take Me into No Hope into what was the last?
False King.
False King. Morgan. You ready for a fucking threefer? I don't know if we've ever done a threefer before.
Oh, menage a trois.
Ooh.
I mean, we spoke French during the show before. Oui, we can speak it some more.
We can speak a little croissant.
Croissant. All right. Well, let's do it. Polarities first with the first ever threefer.
Threefer.
Oh,
the first man.
We're
the
breaking
first
grounds
man. We broke the threefer cherry.
Broke the threefer cherry.
Ooh, ooh.
All right. Let's do it. Polarities. Woo, woo.